Hello everyone, this is your teacher Dr. Priyal Pandey, and in today's lecture we will study about the applications of remote sensing. So up till now we have studied about what is remote sensing, what are the basic components of remote sensing, how to process an image which is taken with the help of sensors, how to interpret an image, what sorts of information which are present in a particular image can be extracted, what is global positioning system, and today we will discuss about the applications with relevance to the precision agriculture. So here are a few applications of remote sensing which are used in today's modern agriculture with the help of sensors. So, what is remote sensing? Remote sensing is basically a technology in which the information of a very far away object are considered with the help of the sensors by detection of the reflected electromagnetic radiations. So there are a few sensors which are used in the remote sensing. One is the imaging sensor and second one is the non-imaging sensor. In the imaging sensor, three types of sensors are used: the optical one, the thermal one, and the radar. Optical sensors basically deals with the visible region of electromagnetic spectrum. Thermal deals with the infrared region of electromagnetic radiation or spectrum, and the radar deals with the microwave region of a particular wavelength in the electromagnetic spectrum. Optical region basically deals in the daytime, and basically red, green, and blue wavelength are considered in this. Thermal have advantage that this type of radiations are studied or can be collected or gathered even at the night time. So basically the heat transmission from a particular object from the Earth's surface are studied with the help of thermal imaging sensors. The radar have a benefit of gather of the information in both day and night time. Radar can see through the clouds, rain, and have a resolution of 1 to 10 meter in space-borne platform, and when airborne platform are used, it has a resolution of 0.1 to 0.2 meter. Ice, ocean, sea, soil moisture, vegetation mass, and man-made object can be studied with the help of radar. Radar have three primary functions. The first one, it transmits the microwave signal to a particular object. Second, it receives the portion of transmitted and back-scattered radiation. And third one, it observes the strength and the time delay of return signal. It provides its own energy, so it is an active sensor. Lie in the range of 1 meter to 1 millimeter. There are various bands in the microwave region of electromagnetic spectrum: X, C, S, L, and P bands. SAR is a type of radar. It is a synthetic aperture radar. So radar basically deals with the soil moisture evaluation. There are few non-imaging sensors. The non-imaging sensors basically do not frame a particular image, but studies the reflected radiation, the intensity of that particular radiation. In this comes first the spectroradiometer. A spectroradiometer is a device which studies the light measurement tool which is able to measure both wavelength and the amplitude of the light which is emitted from a light source. This spectroradiometer measures with precision the radiance, luminance, and the chromacity. It studies the light waves lie in the range from 380 to 780 nanometer and can detect the information within 5 to 10 seconds. Radiometer basically measures amount of light electromagnetic energy which is present within a specific wavelength range. It is expressed in watt and studies the wavelength which lie outside the visible spectrum. Visible and infrared are detected with the help of radiometer. The light range finder studies the reflected light beam, means the laser beam is used to determine a particular object. The laser beam is incident on a particular object, and the time delay in returning back of that particular laser beam is studied. Altimeter is used for studying the height above the sea level. Here are few platforms, few components of remote sensing, sensors and cameras, platform and the application software. Various type of cameras are used in the remote sensing. The red, green and blue camera, NDVI camera, LIDAR, light detection and ranging, thermal sensor, the multispectral sensor, hyperspectral sensors. Three types of platforms are there: airborne platform, flexible unmanned air vehicle, the ground-based platforms. According to that, the cameras are mounted on a particular platform. Here are a few software which helps in the processing of images which are taken with the help of remote sensing. So this is the table representing the satellites on the basis of spatial resolution. There are four types of resolution are there when we talk about the remote sensing: the spatial resolution, spectral resolution, radiometric resolution and the temporal resolution. So all the sensors or any specific sensors do not have all four type of resolution, means it have advantage of one or two type of resolution. On the basis of a spatial resolution, here are few satellites. Few have low resolutions, means they can compare a area or a area at longer distance. Few have very high resolution, means they can detect any differences lie within a smaller range of area, within less than 1 meter of area. The cartosat 2 and 3 lie in the range of very high resolution. It is a list of few programs which with the help of remote sensing are used in the agriculture system of India. Bhuvan is one sort of program. Chaman basically deals with the horticultural crop performance. Fasal deals with the various type of crop weather fluctuations or agrometeorological datas with the help of RISAT and Landsat satellites. The NADAMS basically deals with the drought which prevail in a particular area, district, and how to combat them. Means this program is used in preparation of contingency plan to combat the drought condition prevail in a particular area. So these are few advanced techniques which are used in the India. The remote sensing technique is used for monitoring of yield of a particular crop and mapping of a particular area, because different crops have different yield, or a field can vary, a yield in a particular area can vary on the basis of different type of conditions which are in a particular area, or heterogeneity in a field. By studying that, a map can be generated representing the area having high yield production and representing an area which perform poor or need any reclamation or need any management practices to be applied there. Nextly, the remote sensing techniques or indices which are used during the field mapping are NDVI and GNDVI. normalized difference vegetation index and green normalized vegetation index. With the help of this, any farmer can be guided for nutrient management, weed control, irrigation practices. This remote sensing technique also helps in predicting the drought condition, the soil erosion losses, which type of nutrient deficiency are there, or how to combat the flooding situation in a particular area. This is a false color composite representing various type of various hybrid of maize grown in a particular area. The red color represent the healthy vegetation, and the green color or bluish color region represent the hybrid which perform poor. So with the help of this false color composite, any person can predict that which type of crop variety perform better as compared to other varieties. Evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration is basically made up of two words: evaporation, evaporation from the land surface, and transpiration from the vegetation. This is very highly variable parameter, and it fluctuates with time and space. This is used for assessing and monitoring water availability, drought condition, and crop production. The evapotranspiration cannot be estimated directly. It is estimated with the help of land surface temperature, air temperature, solar radiation, humidity, albedo, and soil condition. There are a few sensors which are used for studying the evapotranspiration. One is the MODIS. MODIS means moderate resolution imaging spectroradiometer, and the next one is the EcoStress. EcoStress is the thermal radiometer which is placed in an international space station. MODIS can take data at weekly interval and have a resolution of nearly about 500 meter. EcoStress have a spatial resolution of 70 meter, and it can take data daily. Here in this image, the evapotranspiration from Nile Delta is taken in a single day, first in the morning time and second at afternoon time. In the morning time, evapotranspiration loss is less from a particular area, and in the afternoon, the evapotranspiration loss is more. The bluish color, the intensity of bluish color is increased in the afternoon, representing higher evapotranspiration loss from the particular area. For soil moisture estimation, the microwaves are considered. The microwaves are best representation for soil moisture. Sensor which is used for studying the soil moisture is SMAP, Soil Moisture Active Passive Sensor. The L band of microwave are considered while estimating the soil moisture. L band radar is used. L band have a frequency of 1.41 gigahertz. This sensor have a spatial resolution. SMAP sensor have a spatial resolution of 9 kilometer, and it depends upon the rainfall, soil texture, vegetation, and topography. Basically, it studies the volumetric moisture content of a particular region. MODIS, Landsat are also used for detection of soil moisture from a particular region. For crop pest and disease infestation, remote sensing images, false color composite are considered. Means the healthy vegetation reflect different type of vegetation, different type of radiation, and the disease infested or insect infested area reflect different type of different type of radiations. Here in this image, three type of images are taken. First one is the true color composite. The next one is the disease incidence image, and the third one is the false color composite. Here there are three arrows. The first arrow represent the healthy vegetation. The second one represent the rice infested with the blast, and the third arrow represent the soybean field. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस टाइप ऑफ इमेजेस, ट्रू कलर, फॉल्स कलर कंपोजिट, एनीवन कैन प्रिडिक्ट द एरिया ऑफ हाई इन्फेस्टेशन, लो इन्फेस्टेशन और नो इन्फेस्टेशन. फॉर क्रॉप आइडेंटिफिकेशन रिमोट सेंसिंग इज वेरी मच यूज्ड. द मल्टी स्पेक्ट्रल इमेजेस, द हाइपर स्पेक्ट्रल इमेजेस आर टेकन फ्रॉम अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया एंड द रिफ्लेक्टेड रेडिएशंस आर कंसिडर्ड. एज द हेल्दी वेजिटेशन रिफ्लेक्ट मोर ऑफ अ इंफ्रारेड रेज एज कम्पेयर टू ग्रीन रेज, ग्रीन वेवलेंथ रेज. द रेड एंड द ब्लू कलर्ड लाइट आर एब्जॉर्ब बाय द हेल्दी वेजिटेशन. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ एनालाइज विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एब्जॉर्प्शन एंड रिफ्लेक्शन पैटर्न ऑफ द लाइट रेज, इट इज ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड, ईजी टू इंटरप्रेट द क्रॉप सिचुएशन, द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बिटवीन अ क्रॉप एंड वीड, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बिटवीन वेरियस क्रॉप स्पीसीज, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बिटवीन अ हाइब्रिड, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ हाइब्रिड कैन बी मेड. द वाटर एब्जॉर्प्शन एरिया लाई इन द रेंज ऑफ शॉर्ट वेव इंफ्रारेड. हेल्दी वेजिटेशन रिफ्लेक्ट मोर ऑफ द इंफ्रारेड रेडिएशन एंड एब्जॉर्ब्स द रेड एंड ब्लू लाइट ऑफ द विजिबल रीजन. एंड डी वी आई इंडेक्स इज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड हियर. द एन डी वी आई इंडेक्स इज नथिंग बट द रिफ्लेक्शन पैटर्न ऑफ द प्लांट फ्रॉम द इंफ्रारेड रीजन एंड द रिफ्लेक्शन पैटर्न ऑफ द प्लांट इन द विजिबल रीजन. सो द डिफरेंस एंड द सम आर मेड फॉर बोथ द रीजन एंड द रेशियो इज मेड. इफ द रेशियो लाई नियर द रेंज ऑफ और इफ द रेशियो लाई बिलो 0.5 मीन्स द क्रॉप हैव सम डेफिशिएंसी और सफरिंग फ्रॉम सर्टेन स्ट्रेस और हैव सम स्ट्रेस. इफ द एनडीवीआई इंडेक्स इज मोर देन 0.5 और लाई नियर द एरिया ऑफ लाई इन द इंड लाई एट द रेंज ऑफ नियरली अबाउट 8.8 to 1, देन इट इज इट रिप्रेजेंट द हेल्दी वेजिटेशन. इट इट रिप्रेजेंट द क्रॉप विथ नो स्ट्रेस. सो हियर द एनडीवीआई इमेजेस आर टेकन विद द हेल्प ऑफ ड्रोन एंड द इमेजेस इन द रेड ग्रीन विजिबल रीजन, नियर इंफ्रारेड रीजन एंड द एनडीवीआई इमेज आर कंसीडर्ड एंड द रिफ्लेक्टेड पैटर्न आर मेड एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन इज मेड. फॉर वाटर रिसोर्स मैपिंग दिस रिमोट सेंसिंग इज यूज्ड बिकॉज द सी विल रिफ्लेक्ट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रेडिएशन, ओशन विल रिफ्लेक्ट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रेडिएशन, the river body, pond, lake all reflect different type of the radiation. Pure water will reflect different sort of the radiation. If there is any suspended particle, then the intensity of the reflection decreases, the pattern of the reflection decreases. Soil mapping can be made with the help of reflected rays interpretation because different soil is made up of different constituents and each constituent reflect different sorts of radiation. So with the help of that a soil can be mapped. The nutrient status of a particular area, a particular field can be made. In this image the performance of various hybrid of corn is made with the help of green NDVI. The variety which perform better is dark green in color, and the variety which is poor in performance of is of yellow color. With the help of NDVI index, GNDVI index, the SMAP eco stress sensor, the soil moisture condition, the precipitation condition, crop production forecasting can be made. The drought can be interpreted with the help of a precipitation pattern of a particular area, the cloud, the weather condition of a particular area. According to that contingency plan can be made for a particular area so that the farmer will not suffer from any loss or have any combating plan to recover from the loss. So this is all about the applications of remote sensing. Thank you.